Good morning, students. Today I am going to explain a new topic, that is lesson number 13, patterns. Patterns. Where do you generally see the patterns? Yes, we see patterns of floor tiles, dress material, and on many more things. When design is repeated in a uniform way, we call it patterns. Now, let us learn what patterns are. Now, students, look at in picture. In everyday life, we see many patterns. And when objects, events, and numbers are repeated uniformly in a specific way, a pattern is formed. For example, we can create various form of patterns using objects, geometrical shapes, pictures, numbers, sound, touch action like a tapping, and the physical action like a clapping and the jumping. Now students, look at in picture, continue the pattern and observe it carefully and see how we continue the pattern.
Now students, I am going to explain the exercise on page number 114, the new topic, that is lesson number 13, patterns. And the first question is, continue the pattern. Now look at in first pattern. The first patterns is downside direction, downward direction. Then the next is right side direction. Third is upper side direction. Fourth is left side direction. And then again continue, that means it is downside, and then it is right side, and then again upper side, and then again the left side. Now we turn to the next pattern, and in next pattern, if we consider the first figure, this part is first part, this is second, and this is third, and this is fourth. Then you can see in the figure, the first part is shaded. Then in next figure, the third part is shaded. Then in next figure, the second part is shaded. And in the fourth figure, the fourth part is a shaded. Then now, if you observe in a second pattern, the first, the odd part is shaded, and the secondly, the even part is shaded. Now in the next pattern, the first part is shaded. Then in the second pattern, third part is we can shade. And now in the third figure, again second part is shaded. And in the last figure, we can shade the fourth part. So in this way, you can complete the second pattern. Students, the third and fourth patterns you can complete in this way. Now we turn to the fifth, and here the patterns are given. The some triangles are drawn here. You can observe the first, then second, then again star, and then the triangle. So I can draw here triangle, and then again the star. And then again triangle, and then again this type of triangle. Now the next is number 6, and here some arrows pattern are given. The first arrow is upward direction, next is downward direction, and then is right side, and then left side, then again continue, that is upward, then I draw here downward direction arrow, and then again the right side, and then again the left side. Then you can complete this way. Then in the seventh pattern, you can complete in this way. You can observe in a second, in first the one cross is here. In the second pattern, then you can increase the one line, that is increase one row. Then in third, again increase one row, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, that means 6. In next, again increase one line, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. And in last one, then I draw first 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then 1, 2, 3, 4, then 1, 2, 3, then 2 and then 1. That is total 15 cross you can draw here, and you can complete the pattern number 7 in this way. Now in second, the 1 into 1, then 2 into 2, you can draw the square in this manner, and then 3 multiplied by 3, then 4 into 4, and then 5 into 5. So in this way you have to complete the page number 114.
Students, today I am going to explain the exercise on page number 115, and the question is continue the pattern. And here the some number patterns are given, and the first number pattern is 1250, then 1300, then 1350. So we have to calculate the difference between the two numbers. So I calculate here the difference, that means we have to subtract the numbers 1300 minus 1250. So 0 minus 0 is 0, then 0 minus 5. So I write here 10, and here is the 2. So 10 minus 5 is 5, and 2 minus 2 is 0, 1 minus 1 is 0. That means our difference is 15 numbers difference. So 1250, then 1300, 1350, this number is 1400, then 1450, then 1500, and then 1550, and then 1600. In the same manner, we continue the next pattern. The next pattern is 5000, 4975, then 4950. So first we calculate the difference between the two numbers. So I subtract these two numbers, 5000 minus 4975. So first we subtract the number. Now I write here 10, and here is 9, and here is the 4. So 10 minus 5 is 5, 9 minus 7 is 2, then 9 minus 9 is 0, and then 4 minus 4 is 0. That means the difference is 25. So the difference is 25. So we have to subtract the 25 from the number. So the answer is 4925. Then next is 4900. Then 4875. Then 4850. And the last number is 4825. So the next pattern is alphabet pattern. Now in this pattern, the first is AC, then DF, and then GI. So first AC, A and C. That means give these two alphabets. Then DF, then D and one skip, and then DF. Then next is G and the R. These two alphabets. So the next are J and L. J and L. So I write here J and L. Then next is M and the one is skip, and then I write O. That means M O. Then next is P. So I write here P. Then skip Q, and then I write R. So P R. Then the next is S and the U, and the next is V and X. V and X. So the pattern is A C D F G R J L M O P R S U and V X. Then the next pattern is Z Y 2 X W 4 and V U 6. Now I explain here. Y Z if 2, then X W is 4, then V U is 6, then T S is 8. This is the 8. Now the R Q, then I write here R Q. R Q is the 10. And the next is P O, that is 12. P O is 12, is the table of 2. 2 is a 4. Then 2, 3 is a 6, 2, 4 is a 8, 2, 5 is a 10, and 2, 6 is a 12.